Welcome back to my channel, Statistics for Applied Linguistics. I'm Dr. Marnie Minegra, and in this video, we are going to look at how to do the write-up for a chi-square, and this is in the results section. So now, if you remember the empirical cycle of research, which I've shown in other videos, the thesis follows the cycle of research with the observation, induction, deduction, testing, and evaluation. The results section is still in the testing portion. So observation is the creation of the idea and the research hypothesis based on information or patterns. That goes in our background section. Induction is the creation of the hypothesis, which is typically at the end of the background section. Deduction is the hypothesis is transformed into a prediction. So we're going to look at how we're going to test that. That is our method section. Testing, the hypothesis is tested. If confirmed, it is provisionally supported. If it is not confirmed, it is rejected and then adjusted. So this is still the results section here. The evaluation is when we're going to look at the results and interpret those in terms of the hypothesis. And we'll look at how to do that in a different video. So in the results section, when you write your results section, you need to first organize the results. So use subheadings to group the results into sections that make it easy for the reader to follow. Then state the findings without a bias or interpretation. The interpretation, it belongs to the discussion section. You do not interpret the results in the results section. You just give the information, the number, the data, the figures. So you can use tables and figures in this section to explain the results. Each test with inferential statistics has a specific way that it needs to be written up. And this is for APA formatting. So we're going to look at the APA formatting for the chi-square. And you can use contingency tables, but only if the information is not a replica of what is in the text. So if you do the write-up in the text, you're not going to include the contingency tables. Now, raw data and contingency tables should go in the appendices. That is, if you do not need the contingency table in the text. And negative results should also be included. Do not cherry pick your results. Do not only show the results that support your hypotheses. You need to also show the negative results and explain why you may have received something that you were not expecting. So here's an example of the introduction to a results section. So here we have chapter 3 results. Notice that we've got different sections here. So section A, 3.1, and then 3.11 overall IC scores. So that's the subheading to this heading here. There's an introductory chapter or introductory paragraph. This chapter presents the results of the statistical tools, descriptive analyses, and coded qualitative data. And then she explains the findings and then how she's going to section things off into section A, B, and C. So this sets the reader up for what to expect in the results section. Now for the chi-square, the output from JASP is going to give us these contingency tables here. We're going to look at the formula. So to report a chi-square, output in APA style, results section, always rely on the following template. The template is the chi-square, in brackets, the degrees of freedom, followed by N equals the sample size, equals the chi-square statistic, followed by p equals the p-value. Now, in this case here, we've got the chi-square. The degrees of freedom is 4. N, if we look at the observed numbers here, we've got 61 plus 5 plus 2, that's 68, equals 207.735. That is our chi-square statistic from the first contingency table. Now, in the case of the p-value, because this is less than 0.001, we actually wouldn't include the equal sign here. So it should just be p is less than 0.001. Now, this is how we would write it up in the text. The chi-square goodness of fit showed that the frequency of responses where the majority of the participants strongly agreed that the language you speak is related to your culture is significant. Chi-square, 4 is the degrees of freedom. N equals 68 equals 207.735, and that should be p is less than 0.001. When you write up your results, You do not need to show the contingency tables. The contingency table should only be shown if you're not discussing the data in the table. If you discuss what is in the contingency table as above, the contingency tables go into the appendices. Now, in the case where you would not want to move the contingency table to the appendancy, I'll show you an example here. This is an example where we've got a lot of chi-squares, and I might only discuss two or three of these chi-squares in the paragraphs within the results section, but then give the rest of the information in a contingency table. In that case, you would put the contingency table into the article itself. Now, here's an example of the write-up of a chi-square in a thesis. So chi-square tests were conducted to determine whether participants' responses to each question would be expected in the general population of secondary level language learners, see table 21 below. And so here, there's no formula. So this is where a table could actually be used. Okay, so do remember, do not interpret your results in the results section. You only present an objective picture of the results in the data, and the interpretation of the results belongs in the discussion section, not in the results section. So this comes to the end of, or this brings us to the end of how to write up the chi-square for your results section. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.